Hola, ciao! We're reading Winnie the Pooh and Tigger too. Oh, my favorite bear besides Jack the Bear and Goldenhair. Oh, yeah. So Tigger is a bouncing tiger. Winnie the Pooh lived in an enchanted place called the 100-Acre Wood. And one day while he was thinking in his thoughtful spot, he was bounced by a springy character with stripes. Boing, boing. Hello, Pooh. I'm Tigger. T-I-double-G-R-E-R. I know you're Tigger. Tigger liked to bounce, especially on unsuspecting friends. Piglet was sweeping leaves and Tigger bounced on him. All the leaves went flying. Oh, Tigger. Oh. Look at you. I just swept all the leaves. And then he bounced on Rabbit. Oh. Doing his garden. Rabbit was happily working in the vegetable garden. Hello, long ears. No, Tigger, don't bounce. Oh, Tigger, you're such a bouncer. Oh, now all my vegetables are going all over the place. Look at that carrot flying. Whiz. Oh, Tigger, look at my beautiful garden. Hello. Yuck, messy, isn't it? Tiger frowned in disgust. What a messy garden. Look at this carrot mess. Messy, it's ruined. Oh, why don't you ever stop bouncing, Tigger? Why? Because that's what Tiggers do. And off Tigger bounce. Tigger, I must bounce. Tigger, doop, 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 doop. And then Rabbit was so upset about his garden that he called a meeting at his house, which Pooh and Piglet attended. Attention, everybody. Sometimes it's got to be done about Tigger's bouncing, and I have a splendid idea. We'll take Tigger for a long explore in the woods and lose him, and then when we find him, he'll be more grateful. Oh, how can I be thankful for you saving me, Tigger? And it'll be like the bounces out of him. It was agreed. They all decided to take the extra hyper Tigger into the woods. So, then they walked in the woods. And then Piglet and the others hid in a hollow log. It wasn't long before Tigger noticed it was alone. I'm alone. Where did everybody go? Now, where did you suppose all long ears went to? Hello. Gee, they must have gotten lost. I better go find my friends. Hello, where's everybody?
We're hiding in the log.
Well, then it seemed clear, and Rabbit crept out of the log and called the others to join him. You see, my splendid plan is working. Now we'll go save Tigger. And as they walked, they kept coming back to the same spot. Oh, Pooh, I think we're lost.
Nonsense, Pooh. I know my way around the forest, and Rabbit left to prove he could find his way home.
Just then, who should appear but Tigger happily pounced on Pooh and Piglet. I thought you fellows were lost, and here you are, my friends. Ah, so happy to see you. You're my favorite friends. Boing, 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 boing. Bouncy, Tigger, bouncy, Tigger. Woohoo! I'm so glad I found you.
We're glad you found us, too.
But Rabbit, turned out, was the only one who was lost. Oh, shoot, where am I? I think I'm lost. Oh, I don't want to tell the others I'm lost. Oh, but Rabbit grew more and more frightened and the thick mist filled with strange shapes and sound. Suddenly he heard, hey! And before he knew it, Rabbit was found and bounced on by old familiar friend. Tigger, you're supposed to be lost. Oh, Tigger never gets lost, bunny boy. Come on, let's go home. And Rabbit took hold of Tiger's tail and Tigger bounced him all the way home. This time, Rabbit didn't seem to mind. Come on, let's go home. Oh, boop, boop. Before long, winter came and transferred the 100-acre wood into a playground of white, fluffy snow. And Roo was so anxious to play with Tigger that his mother, Kanga, barely had time to tie a scarf around his neck. Have him home by nap time, Tigger. Don't worry, Miss Kanga, I'll take care of the little nipper. Then they bounced off because that's what Tiggers and Roos do. Boing, 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 boing. Kangaroo, and Tigger too. Boom, 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 boom. And let's go skating. Woo-hoo, look at, oh, Mr. Rabbit is skating. Oh, can Tiger skate as fancy as Mr. Rabbit? Sure, Roo. Why, that's what Tiggers do best. And then Tigger ran to the ice. He slipped and skated right into Rabbit, and they all went crashing right into Rabbit's front door. Tigger groaned. Tigers don't like ice skating. Oh, man. Tigger and Roo looked for something else to do. Tiggers do best. Roo had an idea. I bet you could climb trees. Oh, Tiggers don't climb trees. They bounce on them. So Tigger and Roo bounced all the way to the top of the tree. Suddenly, Tigger realized just how far down there actually was. Whoa, Tigers don't like to bounce trees. Roo, however, thought that was great fun, and he swung back and forth, holding onto Tiger's tails. Whee! While Tigger was up in the tree, Pooh and Piglet were down below, checking for footprints.
Oh, look at those two, how far they are. I won't know until I catch up to it. Just then, Pooh and Piglet heard a sound in the distance. Hello! Pooh turned to his friend. I hope it isn't Fierce Juggler, because they, hello, and then we drop you. Oh, man, we're stuck up here. Yeah, well, Tiggers like to bounce, and we bounce all the way on the top of your little roof. What are we gonna do? Oh, well, maybe Pooh and little Piglet can help us. Or we could always bounce down. That's a long way down. Yes, it is. But it wasn't Jagular at all. It was only Tigger and Roo up in the tree. Pooh looked up. How did you and Tigger get all the way up there? Well, we bounced up here, Pooh. Oh, well, then why don't you bounce down? Pooh was very smart for a bear of little brain, and so Roo bounced down. But Tigger was still too frightened to jump that far. Somebody help! It wasn't long before Christopher Robbins came to help. Oh, Tigger, what you doing up there? Well, Christopher Robbins, I like jumping around, and I jumped all the way up there. Evan quickly came to the rescue, but no one knew what to do. So you see, Tigger, all of your bouncing has finally gotten you trouble. Who are you? I'm the narrator. Oh, well, narrate me down from here. If you do, I promise I'll never bounce again. So I turned the book sideways, and Tigger slid right down the block to the land of safety below. I turned the book. Do you see? I turned the book. Oh, the narrator, the writer, had to help the tiger get down. Isn't that cute? Yeah, well, that's what teamwork is about. I'm so happy, I feel like bouncing. Rabbit crossed his arms. No, Tigger, you promise. You mean not even one teensy-weensy bounce? Well, Rabbit should have said Tigger turned and walked away.
Well, you know.
Roo turned at Kega's art. Mama, I like the old bouncy Tigger best. And everyone agreed, so they gave Tigger his bounce back and he left for joy. Even Rabbit had to admit, yes, I quite agree. A Tigger without his bounce is no Tigger at all. Doop 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 doop.
I gotta be me, I gotta be me, I gotta be Tigger.
Too, a bouncy, bouncy, bouncy Tigger, Tigger, Tigger. Because a Tigger is a tiger. And I love my friends. Subscribe. And thank you for listening. Have a great day. The end.